हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेरी गुड आफ्टरनून टू ऑल ऑफ यू। यस्टरडे लास्ट टाइम आई वाज डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द मार्केट एनवायरनमेंट, इज नॉट इट? सो आई वाज जस्ट टेलिंग अबाउट द मार्केट एनवायरनमेंट एंड व्हाट आर द फैक्टर्स दैट अफेक्ट द मार्केट एनवायरनमेंट इन द प्रोसेस ऑफ मार्केटिंग और प्रोडक्शन, व्हाटएवर यू से। सो टुडे वी शैल स्टार्ट द चैप्टर मार्केट। Now, when I say market, so far as your syllabus is concerned, the fourth semester, let us divide the markets into three parts. One is perfect competition market, that we find in unit one. The entire unit one is based on perfect competition. Okay. Next market is monopoly, that comes in subsequent units. The third market is imperfect competition, that also come in the subsequent, I think that comes in unit 3. So let us broadly classify the markets into three parts. One is perfect competition, other is monopoly, and the third one is imperfect competition. Now we all know what is perfect competition. We'll discuss about it now. Perfect competition is a market where unlimited, numerous buyers and sellers compete with each other, and there is always a uniform price, identical goods and all that, which I'll discuss now. This is a rare case. Perfect competition is an extreme case, which is never found in the real world in true sense. The second type of market, what I said today, is the monopoly market. Mono means one, poly means seller. So a market where we find only a single seller, existence of a single seller in the market, we call that market as monopoly market, where there is no rivals, there are no competitors, there is no substitute goods, there is no competition at all, and there is entry restriction. There is complete restriction on the entry of new rivals, new firms to the market. So monopoly market also is an extreme case. We don't find monopoly in the true sense, in the strict sense of the term, because true sense of monopoly is absent today. Of course we find some kinds of monopoly. Indian Railway is a monopoly, okay, but still then it's not a true sense of monopoly, because there are other substitutes of Indian Railways also. Even in Indian Railways also, we find different private trains coming out in near future. Okay, we will find private trains running on the same track in Indian Railway. It may be a train of Tata, it may be a Birla, it may be Ambani, anything. But private trains are coming out. As you find in private buses are there, government buses are there. Similarly, in the railway sector also, we are having a transformation nowadays, that private railways, private trains are coming out and they will run on the same track. They will move in the same route as well as the government trains. Okay. Anyway, so true sense of monopoly is absent. True sense of perfect competition is absent. If perfect competition is east, then monopoly is west. So both are poles ahead. They are just contradictory, just opposite of each other. We don't find neither of them in the real world. So what we find in the real world is neither perfect competition nor monopoly, but a market, a type of market which comes in between the two extreme markets. I told you perfect competition to the east and monopoly is the west. Now the markets that come in between the east and west, in between the perfect competition and monopoly, they are called imperfect market structures. Now these imperfect market conditions, they are really found in the real world, and these are monopolistic competition, these are oligopoly, these are duopoly, these are monopsony, these markets you can call them as these types of markets, which is a combination of both perfect competition and monopoly. Some features of perfect competition will be there, some features of monopoly will be there. They will be categorized as imperfect competitive markets. Okay, now that we shall come later. Now today's point of discussion is perfect competition and its features, and how can we derive the AR and MR curves of perfect competition. Now simply, perfect competition, as I told you just now, it is the most ideal market. It is the most ideal market among all market conditions is perfect competition. So perfect competition, the name suggests that it is such a market where there is complete, perfect, unbiased and full competition among buyers and sellers. Okay, jo market re complete, unbiased, full amount of, full degree of competition between buyers and sellers thibo, that market we call as perfect competition. So in this market we find different types of features of this market. Aga dekhiya se market account feature achi ya to syllabus on sabu padauchi ta pore ta bitu posile tar price determination, tar supply curve, short period, long period, tar barriers, different types of jinsa asbo. Okay, first we come to the features. Dekho, first feature is unlimited buyers and sellers. Now it is a market where we find the number of buyers and number of sellers are unlimited, innumerable. One cannot count them. They are just like drops of water in the ocean. If some water is taken out from the ocean, then the ocean level never decreases. If you add some water to the ocean, ocean level never increases. So these buyers and sellers, individual buyers and sellers, are like drops of water in the ocean or single grains of sand in the seashore. So there are large number of buyers and sellers. Second is free entry, free exit. In this market, the entry and exit of the buyers as well as sellers is completely free. There is no restriction on the entrance of any buyer or seller or the departure of any buyer or seller to the market. So everybody is free either to enter the market, to trade there, or to exit the market, or to go out from there. So there is no restriction, it is restriction free. Third is identical goods. This market experiences only one type of good, and this good is identical in all aspects. If I talk of a pen or a white your whiteboard pen, now this pen must be of the same color, same quality, same quantity, everything must be totally same, identical in all respect. No two types of goods are sold in the market of the same product. Okay, next is uniform price. The price level in this market is uniform. That is, every seller, every buyer, they know, or every seller has to sell the product at the same price. The price is fixed prior to their arrival, and whatever price is fixed, that price they have to accept. Therefore everybody has to sell, everybody has to buy in the same price, which is predetermined. I will tell it later how it is predetermined. Now, complete knowledge about the market. Every buyer and seller in this market, they are alert, they are very vigilant consumers or traders. So they are well aware of the market conditions. They are well aware of what price is going on in the market, how much product is available, and where it is produced. So every knowledge of the market, every buyer and seller do possess. So there is no question of any ignorance of any buyer or ignorance of any seller in this market. Factors of production fully mobile. All the factors of production like land, labor, capital, organization, they are completely mobile. That is, they can be shifted to different places as and when necessary. If I am a labor, if I find my wage to be higher in Cuttack, I will immediately switch over to Cuttack. There is no restriction on my mobile, on my going to Cuttack. Similarly, land also can be transferred because ownership can be easily transferred. So land, labor, capital, organization, they are fully mobile. No transport cost. In this type of market, there is lack of any externalities. There is lack of any transport cost. There is, that is, in this market, production, consumption, marketing, everything takes place in the same area, in the same place. So there is no question that there is any transport cost. At present, what happens? Production takes place at, let's say, Mumbai. Consumption takes place at Paradip. So naturally, there is some transport cost involved. But in this market, the question of transport cost doesn't arise. And lastly, normal profit in long run. Now, in this market, the producers get only normal profit in the long period. In fact, we say that in corporate competition, all producers, all firms only enjoy long period, only enjoy normal profit. But remember, in short period, there may be some deviation from this, because in short period, there may be some cases where the producers may reap super normal profit or may also incur super normal loss. But in long period, all firms in this industry, in this market, they all enjoy only normal profit. They can never enjoy any abnormal profit or super normal profit. So these are the features of perfect competition. Now, if this is the features of perfect competition, how can we, next is derivation of AR and MR. How can we derive the AR and MR? Remember, we can derive the AR and MR curve of perfect competition from these features itself. Ame ei feature dioru takar AR MR ku draw kari pariba. Okay? Ar feature kon thila? Na uniform price. Uniform price means all producers, all firms can sell the product, sell their product in the market at a particular predetermined price. They can never sell above that price, they can never sell below that price. So that price is predetermined, predestined by whom? By the industry. Now here comes the difference between farm and industry. Farm and industry. Now before I go to that, let me just make a difference between perfect competition and pure competition. It may also come in the exam. Perfect competition and pure competition. Now perfect competition is a broader concept and pure competition is a narrow concept. Okay, though both things literally means same, but perfect competition refers to a broader aspect and pure competition refers to a very narrow aspect. Now if you look at the features, if you take these first four features, only these first four features, they are unlimited buyer sellers, free entry, free exit, identical goods, uniform price. If you take only these four features, if a market has only these four features, that market is called as a pure competition market. Okay. Now, if a market has all these eight features, then we call that market as perfect competition market. Okay. So, pure competition has a very narrow verge, but the perfect competition has a very wide spectrum. So, perfect competition is much wider and pure competition is a narrow concept of the perfect competition. Hello. Next, coming to derivation of AR. So, uniform price. Here the price is uniform. Suppose I am a farm. Huh. Now, how it is done? Because we have to distinguish between farm and industry. Now, what is a industry? Industry let's say this is the aggregate demand and let's say this is the aggregate supply in the market, in the perfect competition market. Now the point where aggregate demand and aggregate supply meets each other, let's say point E, OQ output is produced, price determined is OP. At OP, In the perfect competition, price is determined, taking into account the aggregate demand and aggregate supply. Aggregate supply means total supply of all the farms in the industry. If there are, let's say, 1 crore farms, farm means small producing units, individual producing units, taking all the producing units total supply, we take it as aggregate supply, and taking all the demand of all the consumers taken together, we make a curve, aggregate demand curve, and the point where they meet is their equilibrium, and accordingly OP price is determined. Now who determines this? This is determined by the industry. Okay, this is determined by the industry. Industry consists of all the producing units, all the farms, and all the consumers taken together, we constitute the industry. So industry here fixes the price. This price OP is fixed by whom? This is fixed by the industry, not any single farm. Any single farm who comes to the industry to transact, to trade, has to accept this price. If it is, this price is not acceptable to the farm, he can well quit. If it is acceptable to the farm, he can well come and have trade. So let us say 3 farms come. This is farm A, this is farm B, this is farm C. So whoever comes, farm A, farm B, farm C, so all the 3 farms, they have to sell their products at this price, because this is the price which is predetermined by the industry, and this is the uniform price which they cannot deviate. They have to sell, trade at that price. So this price, this is the AR of the industry. This is also the AR of the farm. This is also the average revenue of the farm. This is the average revenue of the farm. Okay, so the average revenue of the farm is the price which is given by the industry, and every farm has to accept that. Now this is also the MR. You can say that this is also the MR. Your AR and MR both are same. Why? Now how AR and MR are same? Now remember, here AR and MR are same because you have to sell the product at the same price for whatever quantity of goods you want to sell. You want to sell 1 quantity, you charge OP price. If I want to sell 2 quantities, I will charge the same OP price. Let's say this OP is 10 rupees. If I want to sell 1 product, I will charge 10 rupees. Now if I want to sell 10 products, then I will charge 100 rupees. So here AR becomes 10 rupees, MR also is 10 rupees. Because if I want to produce, if I want to sell 11th product here, then I will charge 110. So the MR is here how much? MR is 110 minus 100 is equal to 10 rupees. And the AR kete hela? 10 tanga. MR kete hela? 10 tanga. Jitti product bikibo, samastankara average revenue be 10 tanga, marginal revenue madhyo 10 tanga. Tenu, eti AR MR curve under perfect competition, remember this, the AR MR curves under perfect competition are same, and they are parallel to OX axis, and they are same. They are not different. AR is not different from AR, MR. They are same and parallel to OX axis. This is because they never fix the price. Price is fixed by the industry, and they only, the farms only, are the price takers. They are not the price makers. The industry is the price maker and the farm is the price taker. Okay? But in case of other markets, excepting perfect competition, in all other markets, in monopoly, in monopsony, in monopolistic competition, in oligopoly, everywhere, we find the AR and MR are different. Remember, in all other farms, except perfect competition, the AR-MR curves are different. In this market, AR-MR are different. This is AR and this is MR. Under monopoly, under monopolistic competition, under oligopoly, everywhere we find Air MR corps are different. Both corps, they are downward sloping. Okay, they are two different corps. Both corps are downward sloping, and also this MR bisects the distance between air and the y-axis. This is y-axis, this is x-axis. MR comes in between air and the y-axis, and MR also bisects the distance. Here it bisects, means just majhe asibo. So it bisects the distance between air and y-axis. So in all other industries, in all other markets, the air MR curves are different and they are downward sloping. But only in perfect competition, the air MR curves are same and they are horizontal straight lines parallel to OX axis. Okay? So this is all about perfect competition features and derivation of air and MR curves. Okay? So next time we shall discuss the different price determination on the perfect competition in short period, in long period, the derivation of supply curves and all that. Okay? Thank you very much. Video dekho. Tomo WhatsApp group re mo video kali kiye share kartilo. Kai share karcho? Jo mane subscribe karna tum channel ko ma dekhau chahu na, let them not see, let them not watch. I don't care. Don't forward this in the group. Jadi se mane subscribe karibe ni तो न देखो सेवन देखी कि आम उपर एहसान करना इफ दे वांट टू सी दे लेट देम सी इफ दे डोंट वांट टू सी डोंट वांट लेट देम सी वी डोंट केयर ओके हम इच्छा देखो इच्छा न देखो बट डोंट शेयर दिस इन द व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप दरकार नहीं लेट देम नॉट बी बेनिफिटेड ओके थैंक यू वेरी मच हैव ए नाइस टाइम